In a meeting attended by various stakeholders, including the Ministry of Health, Transport, Police and Uganda National Roads Authority to discuss ways of reducing road accidents in the country, the Health Ministry directed the resumption of drink driving operations on Uganda roads.
What happened is the person who was driving my car has vanished.
Okay, it's okay. No, just comply with what we are
the
telling
you. The problem is they are making me breathe into this.
Yeah.
And I wasn't driving the car.
You know, no problem. No, but they found you in the steering, isn't it?
No.
According to Henry Mwebesa, the Director General of Health Services at the Ministry of Health, many accidents on the road are caused by drivers who drive while drunk. He adds that drunk drivers can't make right decisions while on the road.
Okay, every effort that is geared towards making our roads safe, as a roads authority, we welcome it. As you know, alcohol has the potential to impair your judgment and ways of response should you be involved in an accident or any surrounding that you may be unfamiliar with. So we welcome it. We hope it will go a long way in solving road traffic crashes and accidents, but also reduce on the number of fatalities we register on our roads.
Kaunyemo operations were intensified in 2015. Drivers started being cautious while on the road. This reduced the number of road accidents in the country. However, the operations were halted due to the outbreak of the COVID-19 pandemic.
And also from the discussions that we had with the police, they guided us that the tubes that we use to blow in are disposable. You are given your tube yourself. You just blow in a machine. You fix a tube, but the machine is, you don't blow in the machine, you blow in the tube. And it is your air which goes through the machine. So, and each passenger or client is given a separate tube which is sealed. So we have concluded that the risk of COVID from that tube is very, very minimal.
Dr. Mwebesa explains that drunk drivers are at a much higher risk of getting involved in road crashes. According to international reports, Ugandans are described as dead drinkers. Surprisingly, many drive.
That is also evident. You drive at night in many parts of this, of Kampala as an example. Akashi Avenue, Bugolobi, Nankulabye, everywhere. People are drinking up to very late, including even weekdays. So I'm not surprised that we are unfortunately holding that gold medal for being the biggest drunkards in Africa. So for that reason, I think the police should be enforced again and supported to check us.
The World Health Organization Road Safety Report 2050 states that there are 27.4 traffic deaths per 100,000 people every year in Uganda. Report compiled by Shamshad Naluja for the news.